tongue and hold my breath. Scared to rock the boat and make a mess.
Hello everyone, have you eaten your lunch or dinner?
Yes.
Okay, do you know where am I, Verduk? Yes, I'm in the kitchen, one of the most important places in our daily life. Why am I standing here? Because I want to introduce some food for you. Okay, the first one, let me check. Look, this is potato. Lot of British people like this, right? And the second food, I want to introduce what this? Yeah, it's rice. For Chinese people like me, rice is the most important staple food in our life. So why I want to introduce these two kind of food for you? Because the essence of these two food is starch. And our topic today is all based on starch. Okay, today's topic is starch processing hydrolysis.
Starch is a carbohydrate consisting of a large number of glucose units joined by glycosidic bonds. Pure starch is a white, tasteless, and odorless powder that is insoluble in cold water or alcohol. It is the most common carbohydrate in the human diet and is contained in large amounts in such staple foods as potatoes, wheat, rice, maize, and cassava.
Okay, then, what is the structure of starch?
Starch molecules arrange themselves in the plant in semi-crystalline granules. Each plant species has a unique starch granule size. Rice starch is relatively small, about 2 micrometers, while potato starches have larger granules, up to 100 micrometers. Do you know the final product of starch hydrolysis? Yes, it's glucose.
I mentioned glucose, right? So what is glucose? Let me give you some chemical background about that.
Glucose is soluble in water, hydrophilic, binds with water and then takes up much space and is osmotically active. Glucose in the form of starch, on the other hand, is not soluble, therefore osmotically inactive and can be stored much more compactly.
Okay, I'll give you a brief introduction about this topic, and in this video, we mainly focus on the process and industry application of starch hydrolysis. Speak of hydrolysis, of course amylase should be mentioned. It plays an indispensable part in the hydrolysis of starch. In fact, it is kind of enzyme. So what are enzymes?
Enzymes are proteins with specific catalytic functions that are produced by all living cells. In common with other catalysts, they are effective in small amounts, remain unchanged after the reaction, and do not affect the position of equilibrium of a reversible reaction. They simply increase the speed at which equilibrium is achieved. Enzymes catalyze reactions by forming a complex with the substrate as active site, and the mode of action of an enzyme can therefore be represented as follows. We can see from this graph, the first step involves the enzyme binding the substrate rapidly and reversibly to give an ES complex. The rate of the individual forward and backward reactions are K1 and K2, respectively. Subsequent chemical changes occur as active site, involving the breaking and forming of chemical bonds to form the products. The rate is characterized by a rate constant. We use K catalyst to indicate this value.
However, due to this special property, there still exist some engineering challenges in this kind of biocatalyst production. Enzymes are proteins, and they are so sensitive to changes in environment in which they work. A change in either the hydrogen ion concentration, pH, or temperature can profoundly affect the activity of an enzyme. Therefore, these conditions are really important in the industry use of enzymes.
This graph shows a pH optimum condition for beta-glucosidase. Above or below this optimum pH, the velocity will decline. For temperature, the same phenomenon happens. Above or below this optimum temperature, velocity also declines. One more challenge of biocatalyst production is enzyme is sensitive to inhibitors. They act by either directly or indirectly influencing the catalytic properties of the active site. It can be concluded that enzymes do play an indispensable part in starch hydrolysis. So how about its industrial production? Recent developments in microbial genetics have created a new potential for enzyme production. The enzyme industry is expected to expand as genetic engineering is applied to the microbial production of enzymes. So what's the process that makes starch into final product fructose? To solve this question, tumor amylase should be considered, fungal amyloglucosidase and bacterial glucose esmerase. Starch slurry is briefly heated to 105 degrees, the granules were and gelatinized giving a paste. Alpha amylase is added at this stage. The temperature is then lowered to 90 degrees and hydrolysis continues for 1 to 2 hours. Then, the substrate is cooled to 55 to 65 degrees and acidified to pH 4.5 before the enzyme is added. The enzyme is embolized in rigid granules, packed into a column, and is fully stable at 60 degrees in a 50% solution of glucose substrate for between 1,000 to 2,000 hours. This is a very successful application of an embolized enzyme in the food industry. How about the industry development of starch? The starch industry extracts and refines starches from seeds, roots, and tuber, provides grading, washing, sieving, and drying. Also, to this day, starch is extracted from more than 50 types of plants. The three varieties that are primarily produced are corn, wheat, and potato starch. The corn wet milling process begins with the production of starch slurry. Okay, let's see from this graph. The coal will firstly go into the shelled coal kernels, and then cleaners, steep tanks, attrition miller, hydroclone separators, grading mirrors, washing screens, centrifugal separators, starch washing filters, and finally, okay, we got the starch slurry. And at the same time, we can see that these four can produce a feed and use for other industry development. And at the same time, these two can also produce some products such as coal oil and gluten. Okay, then how about the production of starch? We can see from this graph, the starch slurry can go into the modification tanks and then dryers, and we can get the modified starch. If directly go into the dryers, we can get the unmodified starch. Or from the dryer to dextrin roaster, we can get the dextrin. In fact, during the industry production, several crucial issues should be considered. Firstly, the emission issue. The various starch production processes include a number of sources of emissions. In coal wet milling, SO2 and odorous vapor emissions come from the steeping tanks and dryers. In addition, particulate emissions come from the loading size, storage size, and product dryers. Okay, secondly, the cost issue. The cost that a wet coal milling firm faces include capture, labor, materials, fuel, and electricity. How to balance this cost to achieve a quality, quantity, win-win situation is significant. Starches have four major properties that are desirable in food and industry use. The first property is that, when heated in water, starch molecules form a paste. This thickening property is helpful in a wide variety of food products such as puddings, gravies, sauces, and in certain industry uses. The second beneficial property of starches is that starch paste can suspend other ingredients or particles, such as fats and proteins in food and clay particles in coatings for paper and some adhesives. The third property is that starch paste can form a gel when they are cooled. This is a desirable quality for use in starch-based puddings, salad dressings, and some adhesives. The fourth property is that starch can form strong adhesive films. This property leads to using starch in paper coating and sizing.
Due to the beneficial characteristic of starch, it can be easily known that the scale of starch production is really large.
According to information collected by the Midwest Research Institute, 17 companies own 47 facilities that currently produce starch in the UK. Of these facilities, 20 produce starch from corn, 3 from wheat, 21 from potatoes, 1 from tapioca, and 2 from other sources.
It can be induced that starch production has bright future. Wet coal mill products are produced and consumed domestically as well as traded internationally. Therefore, domestic producers export some of this product to other countries, and foreign producers supply their wet coal mill products to domestic markets. Besides this, white milk companies have recently made a number of plant openings and expansions and announcements concerning future plant openings. We all can predict that stack production will have a bright future. Thank you for watching.
We clawed, we chained our hearts in vain. We jumped, never asking why. We kissed, I fell under your spell. Love no one could deny. Don't you ever say I just walked away.